see so many of my idols here in one studio.
Unbelievable.
It's great.
It's been a gas from beginning to end.
My fellow cohorts in the victimless crime of rock and roll.
If I had a party in my backyard, this is who I'd invite anyway.
We're all here and it's like one happy family.
It's like one big family, you know.
One big black leather metallic family.
Yeah.
This project took place in the minds of two people first. That was our bass player, Jimmy Bain, and the guitar player in Dio as well, Vivian Campbell. And it came about because of a radiothon that the station KLOS held for 2 days in Los Angeles. And we all took part in it. Jimmy and Viv, in particular, had gone to the station and noticed the lack of people representing our genre of music, our kind of stuff. And felt they might like to pursue it, much the way that USA for Africa did the same. And by pursuing it, we've brought ourselves to this point. Of course, a lot of other things happen in between, and perhaps we'll talk about those too.
The music that's going to be created tonight is going to reach an entirely new and different audience. And what people are finding is that this seems to be a time in history when people are not just directed inward, that they're looking for a way to be directed outward. And when they have the people that they look to leading the way to do that, that they are, in fact, going to follow.
The thing that we're demonstrating, I think, is the power of music as a social maker of social change. Music really can move people to action and can change the course of society and of history. It's kind of neat.
I got asked to do this project by Wendy Dio, and we thought that it was a good cause. I think there's a lot of situations going on in the world right now, without getting too political, where people should become more aware. And if we can accomplish that here doing that this evening, I think we've set out and accomplished what we set out to do.
Musically, it's just a straightforward heavy metal song, very melodic, but Vivian and I have written the music for it.
I was real flattered when Jimmy and Vivian from my Ronnie James band phoned me up and asked me if I wanted to do it, you know, so I said to them, you know, I'm on 24-hour call as soon as you got it ready.
A lot of people involved in this all know each other, and we've probably rubbed elbows and worked together on different occasions before, but never for so worthy of a cause. And everybody who's involved has donated not only their time, but their efforts, their energies, and probably a small part of their soul and heart. And I really feel that we're all in this together. We're all working very hard at it together. And I just hope that the outcome will be indicative of all the efforts that we've put forth together.
Actually, sounds quite good. Are you comfortable with it?
I arrived here from New York without having heard the music, and arrived at the hotel and heard a copy of the track and the melody. Came down here, and lo and behold, there's everyone from the dawn of man in the heavy rock area.
The image tagged upon us is unfortunate because it's not really very true, but we were able to turn a few heads just during the making of the project at A&M. Again, I said we did most of the vocals at A&M and most of the guitars, and we, upon finishing that, had to take more time away because it had to be planned in stages, and again, the nature of this business dictates that who knows where you're going to be Monday or even Monday morning, let alone Monday afternoon. So we had to logistically get it together again, which we did, and finish the project at Rumbo Studios. Rumbo Studios is the studio where we will be also mixing this piece of music. They, like all the rest, have given their help and their hearts and all the great things that everybody has done within this real worthy thing, I think, it has been put together. So not to deter from any of the studios, they're all been brilliant. We could sit here and praise each other for forever, but that doesn't get the money made. So thanks to everybody, and they've all taken great part in it.
We can be strong! We are fire and stone!
Hold on. Stone fell on my voice.
Now we can be strong! We are fire and stone! And we all want to touch a rainbow!
Thanks a lot for the vote of confidence in there, guys.
Now we can be strong! We are fire!
It's great that I get to be asked to sing for a good cause like this, because it just shows that rock and roll is good and positive and help people in many more ways than just going to concerts. So we're helping to feed people and we're helping to make the world a better place. So that's a good thing. And so buy the record. It's going to be great. There's some great people here. There's some great musicians. I can hear them play in the background. And it's going to be fantastic. And I hope everybody pitches in, because it's good karma.
Don't be quite so smooth on some of the lines, all right?
Not so smooth.
The idea of the song being that it's pretty aggressive, because it's a pretty awful thing that we're dealing with.
I know.
You know, and I liked the touch of the rainbow. That was really nice when you went softly into the rainbow. That's nice. Little things like that, but don't smooth it out too much.
I took that off one of your older albums. You know, that phrase was one of your older albums.
I took that in. Okay, I'll try it again.
GQ called back. They said, forget it, Don.
When's this album coming out?
We can be strong. We are fire and stone. And we all want to touch the rainbow. The singers and songs will never change it alone. So we are calling you. Yes, we keep calling you.
They asked us to do the leads, but like I said before, you know, I didn't want to blow these other blokes away. You know, I've been doing this a lot longer than they have. You know, I've got pipes I haven't used yet.
He could break the board.
I haven't located them yet.
He could break the board in there. You know, yeah, it's an act of mercy to the engineers, yeah, that he doesn't sing lead.
Hi, this is Rob Halford, the Beast from Judas Priest. Ronnie invited myself and the rest of the band, but they couldn't make it, but I came anyway, to come down and do this wonderful project. I think it's great because this is the only sector of music that hasn't really done anything in the form of relief for what's going on over in Africa. And it's just a joy to be involved, you know.
Hi folks, I'm Dave Meniketti from Y&T, down here to do the Hearing Aid Heavy Metal for Africa, and seeing some good old friends that we've been playing with for about the past, on and off for about six and a half years, something like that, Dio boys and Journey boys and all kinds of people. It's great to get everybody together for this kind of a thing, because I think rock and roll has, you know, for years had a kind of a fallout among most people, having a lot of bad vibes about, you know, all these devil worships and all these kind of things, and maybe it's a bad vibe for the kids and things like that, but I think it's all a bunch of baloney, but rock and roll is for the kids, it's for everybody. It's an attitude more than anything else, and some people just don't understand that. But we're all down here together to show that we care just as much as everybody else does about famine and people that are in trouble and need our help. And we know that we can do our part and make it worthwhile. And we're all here, and it's like one happy family. It's great. It's a good vibe down here.
These children are starving, and they need to fill their little bellies and their little hearts with hope that somebody cares. Thank you.
We can be strong, we are fire and stone. Dean Martin in it there, isn't he? We can be strong, we are fire and stone. Whoops.
We can be strong, we are fire and stone.
I like it myself.
Okay.
I like it.
Thank you, Ronnie.
We are magic in the night. We are shadow, we are light. We are forever you and I. We are forever you and I.
Right.
Sometime in the night when you're feeling the cold, take a look at the sky above. Those are faces in the light that the story we're told. They are calling you, calling you. Yeah. We are magic in the night. We are shadow.
He's someone who started a dream with me, and the dream of the band that we put together, and now started another dream that he's involved me in as well, and a lot of other people. So I think, you know, it goes without saying how good a player he is, but I think it more should be said about how much he cares and how much he cared enough to start all of this.
We looked through the list of who we had confirmed for this session, and we decided upon that to who we thought was needed for the song, be it as a solo vocalist or as a guitar player. Then a lot also depends on who actually turns up on the day and in what order they turn up in. But I'd say that the biggest problem is probably going to be finalizing what we have. I mean, we're going to have so many guitar solos, and all these guys, I mean, they're all burning, all going for it, and we're playing really, really well. And it's going to be very, very hard to decide, you know, what to use, because we're all putting so much into it. The whole solo, they're all going for it. So I don't envy anyone that task, and that's going to be Ronnie's,
yeah,
eventually when it comes to editing.
We
Yngwie Malmsteen person, you know. And once you get the hang of his name, you know, he's like, he's really incredible. I really did. I bought his album the other day and I threw my guitar out. I said, why bother? Why bother, you know? Use it as a coffee table, you know, because I can't play the thing like that. He's great. I like the way he puts Yngwie J. Malmsteen on his album, so you know, you don't confuse him with all the other Yngwie Malmsteens in the business. Oh yes, sounds a bit like rock and roll, doesn't it?
Happy to be a part of this. I'm glad it's being done. I know it's not the first, but it's a really good thing. And I really get a charge out of playing with all these other guitar players on here. The note density on this recording has got to be some kind of a record.
And everybody in the world, I think, at this point in time, is like clamoring for an opportunity to become involved, to try and right any wrong that they can and to apply their energies into, you know, getting some corn to the starving folks and getting some problems solved over, especially in Ethiopia and around the world, not only in the foreign countries, but right here in the good old U.S. of A. And I was up north fishing, and if I could have stayed an extra couple days, I would have caught enough for everybody. But I figured if I came here, I could at least sing this song that Ronnie and the boys put together and do my part for a cause, you know. And I think America has pretty much made the statement that when there's a problem around the world, that we're the ones who get up off our asses and get to work and take care of business. And this is the Hearing Aid t-shirt right here. And it just shows that the hard rockers, we feel the cause. We might be a little bit late, but we got a lot more energy than the rest of them put together. And I really appreciate, along with everybody else, what the We Are the World and the Band-Aid people have done. And this is an attempt on our part to do it a little harder rock and show them that we care and we got what it takes. And it's the least we can do.
We'll try another one.
It's a real nice thing to be working with everybody, because everybody here are all friends. So this is just like if I had a party in my backyard, this is who I'd invite anyway. So it's a whole lot of fun. I mean, I think it's going to be a real fun thing tonight, and it's going to accomplish a lot of good too. And it's just good for people to realize that heavy metal people do have feelings, and a lot of us have kids. And you could imagine if your kids were starving, you'd want to help too. I mean, we're not these evil people just out for sex and drugs and money. We don't sit back in our limousines and count our money each night. It's this is a job too, and this is one way where our fame can help people, and it's a real good thing that we can use our fame to help. And because whereas if you got a room full of people making a record, who cares? So it's real nice to get together and do this. Thank you. Sorry, guys, our fault. Do it one more time, all right? Here we go.
Hi, it's Carmine of Peace with King Cobra, and I'm here to help out a good buddy, Ronnie Dio, who put all this together, the hearing aid cause to help all the starving people in Ethiopia and around the world, wherever they can use it, I guess. And to me, it's a good cause because I've always been involved with UNICEF and helping people, get food and find water for people and things like that. So I think it's a great cause to put heavy metal and hard rock, heavy bands, all that stuff on the map so people can give us some respect on radio and respect in different places, because, you know, we do get screwed out of a lot of that. And I think a lot of people are going to eat and become healthy because of this thing, you know. So I think it's a great cause.
fucking stars in the world. Good on you.
Well, I'd like to thank everyone who has seen this and who is watching me say these words right now. And I'd like to thank those who would like to pass it on to everyone who doesn't see this, but who listens to the music, to the record itself, and tell you that it's been a real eye-opener to do all of this. And you've been wonderful. I'm going to say that beforehand because I know you will be. All the people who took part were wonderful. And that will be the end of this project. We hope you enjoy it. We hope that we've given you something to make you think. And that's the finish of it. But it's never, ever really the finish. Because after you stop listening to this record, to what I say, people will still be starving. And only you can change it. So if this is the vehicle to make you think, and to make you help another human being, then so be it. We've done our part. Now we should all continue to do our parts forever. Thank you.